Hi everyone, here we have a 2D rig that simulates a 3D head turn in Blender Grease Pencil. Rigged puppet-like characters, like this, can save a lot of time when animating in 2D, while still giving a wide range of flexibility and a highly polished end result. This tutorial does rely on some basic knowledge of Blender, so I have added some links to some excellent tutorials for beginners in the description. I'm also a bit of a beginner, and I'm new to making tutorials, so if I'm moving too fast, using keyboard shortcuts, or doing things that are a bit unclear, please feel free to ask for help in the comments section, and I'll do my best to respond. I've also included a link to the final character blend file, so you can have a play. This video is one of four detailing the character's creation, from sketch to model to rig and finally covering my animation workflow. In this video, we will see how to construct the basic objects required for the rig, from sketch to a fully rendered grease pencil drawing. So here we go. First, we add a mirror modifier. This copies each stroke from one side to the other. That's going to help keep the sketch and the final image from being skewed. It's at this stage that we want to experiment and edit the design while it's still easy to change. However, you'll notice that I change things and modify them as we go from sketch to final drawing, so no worries either way. Using proportional editing by pressing O while in edit mode, we'll move the eyebrows down to give the character a bigger forehead. At this point, we'll stop reflecting our strokes by applying the mirror modifier. That allows us to add some asymmetric parts. You can see that I experimented with a beard and a mustache, though ultimately I decided against both. Throughout the project, you'll see that it's important to stay organized, naming your objects and using collections in the outliner. Placing the sketch in a sketch collection really helps. I end up with just the one sketch, but you could have several. We'll also need to create a grease pencil collection for the final versions of each object. In this collection, we add a grease pencil object called head base. Here we create a new material called line. I chose a brush that I liked, ink pen rough. We could also change the settings manually, but this brush is perfect for what I want. I love its irregular line width. After setting the line material to a muddy brown, I scale the sketch to take up more screen space. Before drawing, we need to add layers for the line and color. Then, tracing the sketch, we make the shape of the base of the face. A cool trick that we can use to check the drawing is to flip it by scaling it on the x-axis. We can do this by pressing S for scale, X for the x-axis, and typing -1 to flip it. This will help us see imperfections, and it's easily undone. Now that we've ensured that our drawings are reasonably balanced, we can add a new material for the skin. On the color layer, we fill the lines with this new material. With that done, we add a new layer for the mouth and start drawing the smile lines, running down from the nose to your mouth. However, because we'll be rigging and animating this, we'll draw this through where the nose will be and past the edges of the face. This will be important for the head turn action, so obviously we don't want this rendered. So selecting the mouth layer, we can check the mask option under the layer panel and select the base color layer as a mask. This will clip the mouth to the edges of the face. Also, on the same layer, we'll draw the actual mouth. Then we add a new object and assign the existing materials. We move it in front of the head and add a line and color layer. While I colored the nose, it was difficult to see until the color covered the smile lines. To avoid this, you can hide the main face object by selecting it by pressing H to hide and Alt H to unhide. I do this later for the ears. For the eyebrows, we create a new material called hair. For the other eyebrow, we can flip it using the technique from before, and then apply the scale by pressing Ctrl A and selecting Scale. In edit mode, we can flip it vertically and edit it with proportional editing. We then add a new material for the eyes. Even though it's identical to the hair material, it's important to keep them separate in case we want to change the hair color. Going back to the head base, we add eye bags on a new layer. To add some extra detail, I'll create a tint material. This is a blushy pink color, and we'll add it to the cheeks, nose, and ears. For this, we'll use a softer, thicker brush. Also, we move the layer down below the line layers. We then add a new layer just above the color layer called shade. The material for this is a dark blue that I draw under the character's eyes and past the sides of the face. So we should also mask this in the same way as the mouth. Check the box and add the color layer to the list. Ultimately, we will repeat these steps until we're done. Create a new object, place in front or behind, add materials and layers, and then draw away. Also, I hid the base head object by pressing H with it selected, so that I could see the covered section of the ear. You'll see the ear design will have changed by the end, but the principles are the same. Once we flip the ear, we can delete the tint in edit mode and redraw it. This is useful to provide some variance when duplicating objects. We're nearing the end, so let's add the hair. After placing it behind the head, we can draw and redraw it until we're happy with it. So let's do the same for the right side and another one on top. So that's it. We're finished with the drawing stage. You'll notice that I have changed the ear design and I added some forehead or frown lines. These are actually called the glabella lines. So if you've learned nothing else today, there you go. With that done, we have all the objects required to rig and animate our character's face. In the next video, we'll be using an armature, lattices, and basic constraints to apply a basic grease pencil rig to our model. Please feel free to ask any questions down in the comments and I'll do my best to answer them. Thanks for watching, and I'll hopefully see you soon.